Good to see you.
You've been with CSEC a while. Have you seen much action?
Well, not as much as you, but yeah, I've seen some interesting things.
I bet you have. Anything in particular that stands out?
I remember this Salarian geneticist I was sent to investigate. That case was a bit disturbing.
What happened? Why were you investigating him?
I was tasked with tracking black market trade on the Citadel. Most of it harmless, nothing I needed to pursue. But during the course of my investigation, I noticed an increase in the trade of body parts, organs mostly. We usually get a few of those, but not the numbers I was seeing. We weren't sure if there was a new black market lab or if some freak was harvesting organs from citizens.
You've seen this before on the Citadel?
Every so often, some lab sells unwanted parts through the black market, but they're not as bad as the psychos. I remember this one Elcor diplomat we caught in my first year on the job. He was hacking people up and selling their organs, had the station in a bit of a panic. But this case wasn't that clear-cut. Turns out there was more going on than we first realized.
So how did you figure out what was happening?
First, we got a hold of a sample and ran DNA tests. The weird thing was, the match led us to a Turian who was still alive and was very convinced he'd never lost his liver. After a bit of digging, I discovered this Turian worked briefly for Dr. Saleon, the geneticist. So I went to his lab hoping to find evidence of cloned organ development, but there was nothing. No Salarian hearts, no Turian livers, not one Krogan testicle.
You're kidding, right? Why would anyone want Krogan testicles?
Some Krogan believe that testicle transplants can increase their virility, counteract the effects of the genophage. It doesn't work, but that doesn't stop them from buying. They'll pay up to 10,000 credits each. That's 40,000 for a full set. Somebody's making a killing out there.
What'd you do about the geneticist?
I brought in some of his employees for interrogation, to see if I could get them to talk. While I was interviewing one of them, I came across something suspicious.
You mean threatening? Was that really necessary?
Maybe, maybe not. Either way, it paid off. One of my detainees started bleeding profusely during the interview. We offered to patch him up, and he got frantic, freaked out. I ordered a full exam to find out what was going on. Our medics found incisions all over his body, some of them fresh. That was our big break. These people weren't just Dr. Saleon's employees. They were test tubes. Walking, living test tubes.
He was growing parts inside these people?
Exactly. He cloned their organs right inside their own bodies. Then he harvested them and sold them off. Most of the victims were poor. He'd pay them each a small percentage of the sales, but only if the organs were good. Sometimes an organ wouldn't grow properly, so he'd just leave it in them. Most of them were a mess, but only on the inside, hidden so nobody could see it.
I hope he got what he deserved.
That's the worst part. We never caught him.
Why not? What the hell happened?
He ran, blew his lab, grabbed some of his employees, and headed for the nearest space dock. By the time I found out, his ship was already leaving. He threatened to kill his hostages if we tried to stop him.
But you went after him anyway, right?
I ordered Citadel Defense to shoot him down, but CSEC headquarters countermanded my order. They were worried about the hostages, worried about civilian casualties if the ship was destroyed so close to the Citadel. I told them those hostages were dead anyway. He just used them to make more organs, but they wouldn't listen.
Well, you can't get them all.
No, but letting him get away like that. All they had to do was disable that ship, stop him from running. Maybe the hostages die, maybe they don't, but at least we stopped the bastard responsible for it all.
I suppose I can see both sides. But what's done is done.
I suppose. Can't waste too much time worrying about it now. Just wish I could have stopped him. That's all.
Do you have any idea what happened to Dr. Saleon?
I sent out feelers from time to time, hoping to find something. I thought I'd found him a while back. He changed ships and changed his name to Dr. Hart, his idea of a joke, I guess. I told the military, but they weren't convinced it was him. I got the transponder frequency for his new ship, but I just can't get anyone to check it out.
I'll check out the coordinates when I get a chance.
I was hoping you'd say that. But Commander, take me with you when you go. If it's Saleon, I want to be there when you find him.
Commander?
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink. Bit of a celebration. If you're interested.
What's the occasion?
It's Armistice Day, when the First Contact War ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
There's almost nothing in your files. Technical scores and a list of crap assignments.
There's a reason for the crap assignments. I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shan Xi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
Don't tell me you're blamed for that.
Not formally. Dad got passed for promotion over and over. And I think my record merits more than garrison duty in a backwater agri-colony. Takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
What happened to your grandfather after the war?
He was relieved of command as soon as Shan Xi was liberated. They brought him back to Earth in irons, but there was never a trial. They quietly demoted him and stuck him behind a desk. He retired a year later and spent the rest of his life working construction in the colonies. Sometimes we hear about attempts to get him exonerated in some official way. Nothing ever comes of them.
As I recall, your grandfather held out for a long time.
The Turians wrecked the orbitals in the first wave and occupied the major cities. They sat in orbit, dropping rocks on anything that moved. Granddad dispersed the troops. But when they went into the cities for supplies, the Turians would wreck a block to eliminate one fire team. Civilians were dying, his troops were starving, and he couldn't contact Alliance High Command. So he surrendered the garrison.
Is this why you're always going on about the Council?
If everyone else can look at Shan Xi and say, this is why humanity needs to be stronger, then so can I. I'm entitled. So now you know. Gonna kick me off the ship, Skipper?
You're a valuable part of my crew, Williams. If I want an opinion from the head, I go to Alenko. When I want one from the heart, I go to you.
I also play a mean game of pool. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.